Yeah, so the last couple of videos included a lot of mathematical details, which may not be super exciting. So let's now take a look at a more hands-on example and do something, more hands-on, training an adaptive linear neuron in Python. So here I will just give you the overview of how things relate to the Adaline. So recall the Adaline. That is what we covered briefly in the history of deep learning lecture. That is a model by Widrow and Hoff developed around the 1960s. So actually it was a physical device, but you can of course also nowadays implement it in software. And this is a nicely differentiable neural model. So the perceptron model that we talked about before is not differentiable because of this threshold function. So this Adaline, you can think of it as an advancement of this perceptron that is now also converging even if the data is not linearly separable. So just for comparison, so how the perceptron looked like. So recall in the perceptron, we compute the net input first, and then we pass the net input through a threshold function, and then the threshold function produces our output. So the output is the predicted class label, which can be either 0 or 1. And if the prediction matches the actual label for that given training example, then we don't do anything. But if it doesn't match, if it's different, then we have this error term that we computed, so the difference between the two, and we use that to update the weights. So we update the weights, which then will change the decision boundary to make the prediction correct. So that is how the perceptron works. But a threshold function is not differentiable, so here we couldn't use calculus. There was just this rule that was developed by, I would say, thinking hard about this problem, so it was more like an empirical update rule. Now we can actually improve that by using calculus. So at the bottom is the Adaline. So here you can think of this part here as the maybe base model, and this is like linear regression works. So again, we also compute the net input similar to the perceptron. Now we have as an activation function, we have this identity function, which is not doing anything. So if it's not doing anything, if my activation function is just the identity function, why do I write it down in the first place? That's because next week or the week after that, we will be talking about nonlinear activation functions. We will be talking about functions that are, for example, a sigmoidal function like this one, for example. So we will be covering other types of activation functions, and we will need them to develop multilayer networks, because this will help our multilayer network to produce nonlinear decision boundaries for solving complex problems. Because if we would be using linear activation functions in a multilayer neural network, then the multilayer network would be just a combination of linear functions, and the sum of linear functions is also just a linear function, so we wouldn't gain anything. So later on we will be talking about nonlinear activation functions, and here you can think of it as a placeholder. We will replace that later. I'm just including it here in the notation because it's a more general notation that would apply to also nonlinear activation functions. Okay. Now consider this linear regression base. In order to turn this linear regression model into an adaptive linear neuron, into the Adaline model, all we have to do is now adding a threshold function, because the Adaline model is a classifier. So this is a classifier for classifying data points, similar to the perceptron. However, note the difference here really between the perceptron and the Adaline is where we compute the error. So for the perceptron, we compute the error after the threshold function, and in the Adaline, we compute the error before the threshold function. So here we don't have the problem that things are not differentiable because we computed before the threshold function. The threshold function still is not differentiable, but we don't worry about that because we compute the gradients before that. So in that way, it's not a hindrance. And it will become more clear when I show you the code example. So here's just conceptually how it looks like when we fit an Adaline model. So here what I'm just doing is I'm showing you the class label on the y-axis. So for binary classification, where we have two class labels of 1 and 0, I have plotted them here. So the class labels can be either 1 or 0. And then we have only one feature value for simplicity here. And yeah, we want to predict that. And the linear neuron is a linear model. So essentially what it will learn is will fit a linear line similar to linear regression. So this would be very similar to linear regression, right? Except now the difference is really that in linear regression, we usually have continuous values, not only zeros and ones, and we don't have the threshold function. So in the Adaline, after fitting this model, we apply this threshold function, let's say at 0.5 between 0 and 1, and we say then if something is bigger than a certain value, so if the it's maybe a little bit unfortunate that I wrote class table here because this is a threshold. If the prediction, let's say prediction, if the prediction is greater than 0.5, produce class label 1, and otherwise produce class label 0. So in that way, we turn the continuous prediction into a class label. Again, this will become clear when I show you the code example. So I prepared some code examples. Let me pause this video and do this in a fresh video. So there will be another video where I will go over these code examples.